presented by BMO Harris Bank. This is Big 12 Sports Saturday with 540 ESPN.
And thank you for joining us on a web-only special edition of Big 12 Sports Saturday with 540 ESPN. I'm Dan Needles. He's Drew Olson. Drew, we're at this weird point in the year where all of the sports have converged together. We have the baseball playoffs. The NFL is well into the regular season. NHL has started its regular season, and NBA training camps are open. We're not going to talk about all of them. Let's focus on the NFL right now, because I think that's what most people here are focused on. We are at the quarter pole of the season. Okay, what have we learned about the NFL this season?
Well, I was not buying the Denver Broncos early, all the preseason hype, and I see now that I was wrong. They're really good. And I think they're formidable. And people say, well, Peyton Manning's going to run out of gas in December and January.
That.
You say that. I think he might be poised to keep it going.
I can't get the thought of Brett Favre in 2007 out of my mind. In the NFC Championship game, in overtime, he didn't look like the Brett Favre we had seen before who loved playing in the cold. He looked like a mortal human being who was cold and who wanted to get out of there. Yeah. And threw one up for grabs that shouldn't have been thrown. And I have a feeling something like that might happen with Peyton Manning at some point this season, because he is getting old.
In Denver, it can snow in October, and it could be 70 degrees in December.
This is true.
We'll have to see. But they look really good. And, you know, I think the injury thing is, again, why do we always forget this, that teams that look really good right now, as we're in early October, are an injury away from being, you know, on a four-game losing streak.
No doubt about it. We just saw with the Cleveland Browns, who, after 2 weeks, were written off as the worst team in the league because they traded Trent Richardson, their best offensive player. They had to start a third-string quarterback in Bobby Hoyer. And then they win three games in a row, but then they lose Hoyer. So now they're back to Brandon Whedon. And they could end up losing six games. Who knows with a team like that? But there are, through the first quarter of the season, I think we both have an idea who we think are the best and the worst. Coming into the season, I thought San Francisco, Houston, Atlanta were the three best teams in the NFL. They're all mediocre at best right now. So who do you have as your top three teams right now?
I would have to say Denver's playing better than anybody. I think Seattle's shown that they can win on the road. That was a wrap against them, is that they're tough at home and that awesome field advantage with the noise and everything.
To win at Houston after being down 20-3.
To win at Houston was big. I mean, that was kind of a statement game for them. And I got to go with New England. I mean, look, they had so much off-season, you know, bad publicity with the Hernandez case and everything, and you thought, well, maybe this is the year that they start to level off a little bit, but they're playing very well. They're winning games. They haven't been awesome. They haven't been knock your socks off good, but they're good enough to win, and you can't count them out.
And Tom Brady had they replaced his top five receivers, I think, from last year, or they haven't been available, which blows my mind. But then again, their first three games were against three of the worst teams in the NFL. The win over Atlanta really impressed me because it was at Atlanta. This was the Falcons' chance on national TV in a marquee game to show the world, yeah, we are a legitimate Super Bowl contender. And they failed miserably in that game, even though the score was a lot closer than it should have been. I wanted to put New England in there, but I believe too much talent has left that team since last year. I have the same two, Denver and Seattle, right now, but I'm going to go with Kansas City. And I know it's kind of a bandwagon thing right now, but they had, what, six Pro Bowlers last year on a team that won two games, which was an indication that the coaching wasn't up to snuff and they had some talent. You bring in Andy Reid, you bring in a quarterback, Alex Smith, who has been ripped for most of his career, but the last couple of years he really played well in San Francisco. It just so happened he got hurt and Colin Kaepernick came in and stole the job away. It's a conversion of a lot of different things. I'm not saying Kansas City is going to win the Super Bowl or anything like that. But they have a really good defense. Well,
at the quarter pole, I can see why you'd put them there, but Alex Smith will turn into Alex Smith, and you'll see, I think we'll see as we move forward, some of the reason that they did win two games last year, because it's hard to make that big leap.
It is.
It's fundamentally the same team. Coaches are important, but not that important.
And the one thing that normally I would say, you know, if you're in a bad division, you can make that leap, but they're in a division with Denver. So it will be really difficult for them to make that leap with Denver not being in the way.
The interesting question now is, where do you put the Packers? Neither one of us has them in the top three. Where are they in the slot? Because I see them in that 4, 5, 6 range somewhere, maybe around 5.
I see them more around 8 or 9 right now until they prove more. They beat a bad team. That's it in Washington.
Yeah.
But not the worst. We also have a list of each of us. The three worst. You start.
I think the three worst for me could be just the Jaguars. I mean, they're all three. They're as bad as it can be right now. The Jaguars could be 1, 2, and 3 on my worst teams, and then we'll start with 4. No, I have Jacksonville's terrible. I don't think the Rams are any good.
Ooh.
I don't. They're going to fall apart. They're going to crumble.
Well, that
Watch.
Makes for a marquee matchup this week.
That's right. As we tape, they're getting ready to play. And then Oakland is, I think, horrible
really?
Too. Yeah. I mean, quarterback situation is quarterback's everything, and they don't have that ironed out.
To me, Jacksonville slam dunk, obviously. But number two, Tampa Bay. And it's not just Josh Freeman's fault. Greg Schiano has lost that team in a hurry. And it'll be interesting to see how they respond. We've seen some other NFL teams this year make a quarterback change and then win right away. It didn't work for Tampa. They should have beaten Arizona. They didn't.
You may see them rise up, though, against the coach, and they'll coalesce against the coach and play. That's kind of the other side of it. It's like, yeah, the wheels can come off in a bad way, but it can also be, you know, screw this guy, let's play for each other and let's make it happen. And Schiano's got to be a short timer.
I would think so. I'm sure he's going to regret leaving Rutgers. My third team on the bad list, Pittsburgh. They got old in a hurry. They lost a lot of talent on offense and defense. Their offensive line is worse than the Packers. And I thought the Packers going into the season were going to have a bad offensive line. They run block. They're protecting Aaron Rodgers a little bit. They're making Pittsburgh, they look like Pittsburgh Lions of the past compared to this Steelers offensive line, and that's the key to everything.
I wouldn't put them on that list just because there is talent there, and I just have faith in that organization and just the coaching staff and that they're going to get it ironed out. Kind of like the Giants, nobody's mentioning them as one of the worst teams, even though they're off to a terrible start. You know, you just have a feeling that they're going to rise up, that they could catch fire somehow, some way. It's been bleak, I admit, and so far it's hard for me to argue with that. But I think that there's something there. There's just that pride of being that organization. And to see them fall that far that quickly would be surprising.
We could talk NFL all day long.
And we do.
And we do, yes, on the D-List on 540 ESPN. Make sure you join us on Big 12 Sports Saturday with 540 ESPN. Normally we're on at 6:30. This coming week we'll be on at 6 right after the Badgers game against Northwestern. Thanks for joining us on a web-only special edition of Big 12 Sports Saturday with 540 ESPN.